appointed as a mission commander for the operation going to evacuate South Africans in Wuhan, bring them to South Africa. The initiation of the mission was on the 1st of March when the interministerial task team was at the OR Tambo, now telling South Africans that members of South Africa who were stranded in China were going to be evacuated within 10 days from the 1st of March. Then that's when the whole mission now was set in motion, where now people were then brought together, the military health service set and planned, and then members were nominated, were going to take over this mission. And then I was called somewhere in the middle of that and told that there is a need for a mission commander for the mission. Then I was brought in, I agreed to the mission, and then I started now carrying on with the planning. Up until then, we were told that by the 10th of March, then we must leave through with SAA and then go to Wuhan to go and pick up South Africans. Now, we left on the 10th of March in the evening. We left roughly just after 10, after the president had addressed both the military personnel as well as SAA crew at the airport to say farewell, go well, go bring South Africans and then bring them alive. We left, we flew, we landed in Clark in Philippines, where we had a 48-hour layoff for the pilots, the flying crew, because they need that time, according to Civil Aviation Authority, to rest after they've been flying for so many hours. We were there, we arrived in Clark on the 11th, we spent the 11th up until the 13th, then we were now preparing because people who were the South African Embassy in Beijing was busy organizing everyone else, getting them to the airport so that they are screened and then we know the exact number of the people who are going to be evacuating from China. Up until roughly around 9 o'clock in the evening on the 13th, when we had to fly now over to Wuhan to go and receive the South Africans that were there. We spent roughly 3 hours in Wuhan at the airport where the screening happened, the whole immigration process up until the people got into the aircraft. Ourselves, prior to that, we had our own training, you know, while we're in South Africa to prepare for the mission because we have to do mission readiness training. We knew the mission that was in front of us, so we had to prepare everyone else, both SAA crew as well as the healthcare practitioners from the military as well as Department of Health who were responsible for this mission. We had to get the required stocks in terms of PPE for both SAA crew as well as military personnel, and then now to prepare also for the PUIs that we're going to pick up from Wuhan. We went through the rehearsals in South Africa on the plane when we got into Clark for that time period that we were there. We did our rehearsals, we did our final briefing on the 13th before we went to the airport. When we got to the airport, we went again through the rehearsals because we had divided the aircraft into three zones. The green zone, which the flight deck crew was, the pilots, as well as the yellow zone where the staff members were going to be sitting, SAA crew as well as the healthcare practitioners, and then the red zone, which was the rear, the economy class of the aircraft, where all the PUIs were going to be. So we had to go through the whole process, setting up isolation chambers just in case we have someone who is suspected to be positive, so that we can isolate them from the rest of the people. All that process was done, we had enough stock in terms of PPEs, people. We had one channel of movement. We move in from one side of the plane, we come out the other side. So we have to keep one side clean. The other side, we know that it's relatively contaminated because you're coming from the people that are suspected to be having this COVID-19. And then we had people to make sure that there is no cross-contamination in between the yellow zone as well as the red zone and the green zone, meaning that both from SAA as well as from the healthcare practitioners that were in the plane. That was done up until we received the people. But we had plans that as soon as the PUIs arrive, then we must start with the medicals. Initially, from the time that they get into the plane, as well as they were screened before they come to the plane. When they enter the plane, then we have to screen them also, check their temperatures, because if someone has got a temperature that is suspected of being high, then they don't get into the plane. But then we screen them, everyone else was fine, they all got into the plane. But we were told that because we're going to pick up about 118 people, but then we're told that there was another four that were unable to come to the plane because they were found to have raised temperatures. Then the Chinese authorities, then they had returned them, quarantined them, and then test them to see if they don't have any, COVID-19, in them. That was done. The 114 that we picked up, 112 of them were the PUIs, and then the two members were the staff members from the embassy, one from Home Affairs and one from DERCO. We carried on with them. When we took off from one, roughly after 3 o'clock in the morning, we started with the temperatures, medicals, all of them, so that we can understand basically what are we dealing with. Is there any issues that we might, you know, we must look out for when we're in the quarantine, when we arrive in Polokwane. And then we had 4-hourly checks in terms of temperatures of everyone else while on flight. And we had roughly just over 13 hours of a flight from one up until we arrived in Polokwane at the ranch after 11 o'clock Bravo time, you know, on Saturday the 14th. On arrival, everyone else, because we had buses that were waiting for the members, both the SAA crew, military personnel, as well as the PUIs. Buses covered in, so that if there's any chance of infection, it doesn't get spread across everyone else. So the buses were allocated, and then minimum number of people were put in the buses, so that at least we maintained the social distancing, as it was one of the guidelines, because it was mandatory, it was not an optional issue, because we want to keep the people away from each other, so that if anyone has an infection, there's no cross infection of everyone else. That was done. The buses were enough. Everyone in the buses, SAA crew as well as the military members, we drove from Polokwane Airport up until we got to the ranch in Polokwane, where the quarantine was going to take place. The mission, like any other mission, always has got its own challenges, but those were teething issues because it was the first time that this kind of mission was done in South Africa. And then it started well, people were accommodated, the rooms were already prepared, and then everyone else was sorted out. As soon as everyone was sorted out, now we had to sit down now and do medicals of everyone else, as well as prepare to do swab tests so that we can now send the specimens to the lab to see if we cannot pick up any viruses from the swabs. That was done, I think, on the first day, 14th we arrived, on the next day, then on Sunday, then we started doing all those tests. The results came within 24 hours, and then everyone else initially was negative. And then there was no other issues that were actually, that were a worrying factor in terms of medical tests that we did for the members. We kept the members in there, we kept on briefing them, because we had, as part of us, the whole team was consisting of doctors, emergency care practitioners, nurses, as well as a psychosocial team. Now we had groups where the psychosocial team was working, the psychologist as well as a social worker with the members, because they had to be debriefed, they had counseling, those who had issues to talk about, then they set up appointments. And then every day we had a routine, because in the morning we had to do temperatures for all these members from the day we arrived up until the last day when they left. So routine medical checks, we do temperatures in the morning for everyone. That now includes the PUIs, the staff at the ranch, SAA crew, as well as healthcare practitioners who were part of that, because everyone, we had to monitor them closely, so that if there should there be anything that we pick up, we can easily isolate them while waiting for the results to come. That process carried on up until on the 27th of March, when we did the last swabs, and then we received the results just on the 28th in the evening. Then the 29th, the president came in, declared the place coronavirus free, and then we handed the people to the president, because now the Department of Higher Education was going to take over the next phase, which is the third phase of integration in terms of transporting the people from the ranch itself to wherever they're going to be going, you know, into their families. Then now we left the ranch, decontaminated the rooms, because we had a team that was a CB team that was ready to decontaminate the rooms after the people have moved out, so that we leave the ranch as clean as we had found it, you know, initially. Well, currently I'm in the unit. I'm preparing my unit in terms of, should there be a requirement for us to provide support as a unit, then we are preparing for that. And then I'm busy providing medical support to support Operation Otlela in terms of support to the infantry troops who are supporting the police on the ground. And then we're preparing our healthcare facilities. Should there be a need for them to be deployed, then we will deploy them. And then advisory role is just one of those that I am busy with currently. I am Colonel Mcebisi Zukile Mdutywa, Officer Commanding of 7th Medical Battalion Group. South Africans, please stay at home, adhere to the lockdown rules, and be safe.